Let me say a very warm thank you for organizing this Durbar to climax a day of interaction with the Anglo Traditional Council. I have spent the morning, since I arrived this morning, in a meeting first with Ahomefia and his immediate lieutenants, and then again in a general meeting with the Ahomefia and members of the Anglo Traditional Council. Our interactions this morning have been very fruitful, and I believe that it is an interaction that we must continue into the future. We've been very frank and civil in our discourse, and I believe that this discourse and discussion we've had this morning have brought us onto the same wavelength. In our discussion, we agree that social development is taking place in respect of school blocks, in respect of CHIPS compounds, health facilities, in respect of construction of office complexes, extension of electricity, water, and other social development is taking place at a fast pace, and that what we need to focus on is to focus on the issue of economic infrastructure and establishment of livelihoods for the people of the Southern Volta. And I had the pleasure to mention to Ahomefia and the members of the Traditional Council that Cabinet had approved and passed on to Parliament an exploration agreement for the Swiss Africa Company to begin exploration in the Keta Basin for oil and gas. We also discussed the Southern Volta Basin Development Authority, which is an authority that is dear to the hearts of the chiefs and people of the Southern Volta. We're going to start the feasibility study for the establishment of a deep sea port in Keta. And so that is also one of the issues we took up. But in the meantime, we're working on the landing sites. As you are aware, we identified 11 landing sites under the China Development Bank loan. The loan stalled, that facility, even though it was approved by Parliament, it stalled. But recently, I've set up a task force to revive the China Development Bank facility. And that task force has been working assiduously. And it is my hope that the various sites that were identified to receive the fish landing sites will soon see work on those landing sites. We also are going to improve the road network in the Southern Volta area. And so several roads have been identified for work. Already I announced that the town roads for Keta are going to be tackled, and it's been awarded on contract. The same contractor is working on the whole town roads on Hohoi, and he's the same contractor going to work on Keta town roads. As you've heard, he started with Ho, and he's going to start Hohoi, and soon in Keta, you will find him working here. While he's working, we are packaging Angloga, Denu, Agozomi, you know, town roads for special attention. So several other communities will be added as the work continues. I also raised the issue of land tenure. One of the major ways in which we can create economic prosperity in this area is to partner with the private sector. And so get the private sector to come into agri, into manufacturing, into agro-processing, rice farming, rice milling and processing, and all that. We need the cooperation of the chiefs to help us to resolve the issues of land tenure. If a private sector individual wants to establish a business, often if he has to take a sizable piece of land, the number of families and individuals he has to deal with run into the hundreds. And often these projects are bogged down with litigation. And so I asked Ahomefia and the Traditional Council to see how we can identify potential private sector investors and ensure that we give them access to land without the litigation that accompanies it. But finally, I just wanted to note that we are in an election year, and often there is political propaganda. Of course, our opponents note that the Volta region is the World Bank of the NDC. And I said it's not only the World Bank, it's also the IMF of the NDC. And so whatever our opponents can do to discourage you, to make sure you don't come out in your numbers and vote, they will do. And that is why you have activists, known activists, they are not NDC members, who come and parade and pretend to be NDC youth and agitate our young people and say that NDC has not done anything for you. That is absolutely untrue. Every progress that has been made in this region in terms of electrification, water, and just name any infrastructure has been done under an NDC government. From Jerry Rawlings' time to Professor Mills' time to my time. And for those who do that propaganda, I mean, in the 8 years when they had the opportunity, what did they do? Show me. And so we will not be distracted, like the regional minister said. We're doing a lot of work. We have built a new campus for the University of Health and Allied Sciences. The Volta region did not have a public university. And one of the campuses of the University of Health and Allied Sciences is coming here to cater. The School of Pharmacy is coming to cater. And it's not like a few, it's in the future. They are starting recruitment admissions for the School of Pharmacy here in Keita this September to open the School of Pharmacy. And so often that propaganda makes people believe that nothing has been done, even when they can see that a lot of work has been done. And so I ask you to discount it. This government stands for you, will never take you for granted, and will make sure that the Volta region gets its fair share of the national cake. And so finally, considering that we are on the grounds of Kitasco, I was looking at the performance of secondary schools across the country, and Kitasco was identified as one of the best performing secondary schools. And so I want to congratulate the staff and faculty of Kitasco for the good job that you're doing. I want to congratulate the head boy and the head girl for the good job you're doing. I hear you are preparing for the senior secondary school certificate exam. I wish you good luck, and I hope that you will maintain the standard that your predecessors have set. I want to come back next year, and they'll say that when this batch left, they even bettered the standard of their predecessors. And so, good luck in your studies, and may you all come out with flying colors. I thank you very much, and God bless our homeland, Ghana. Well done.